along. I'll just give people maybe a minute or two just to get logged on there. Ellen, how are you? Jennifer, good morning. Good to see you. Great to have you here with us. Helen, hello. It's great to be back live. As you know, the last two movement minutes that we did were pre-recorded. So it's great to be back here with you live. That's something we enjoy, and it's definitely a part of our day that we look forward to. So it's great to be back here with you. Finbar's there as well. Good to see you, Finbar. Great to have you here. And we have people. Yeah, they're all starting to log on. Mary, how are you? So it's Friday, folks. And as you know, this is our seated and standing session. Now, for the last few Fridays, because we've been able to adapt our exercises both to seated and standing positions, what I'd like to do today is maybe change it up a bit. So instead of doing the games, we're just going to do it here in the living room where we normally are during the week. I'm going to do it from a seated position, and Siobhan's going to join me in a while, and she's going to just demonstrate the standing versions of the exercises that I'm doing. So whatever you choose to do today, whether it's seated or standing, we'll be able to show you variations of each exercise in that as well. And we have a little surprise for you at the end as well. Not sure if you're going to like it or not, but I hope everyone does. So we have people, yeah, they're flying in there now. So we have Kathleen, Fiona, Roz, Marion, how are you? Caroline McSweeney, Angela, great to have you in here today, folks. Hope the sun's shining where you are. That is here at Movement Minutes headquarters, anyway. So we'll just give it another few seconds, folks. The numbers are shooting up there. It's great to have everyone here today again. And I hope all your partners are, if partners at home, that they're joining us today as well. If you got them roped into the exercises during the week, I hope they can finish it off now with us as well. So before we begin, folks, I'm just going to give the hands a quick wash, and if that's available to you as well, I'm just going to put a bit of disinfectant on there. If that's available to you, I'd ask you just give them a quick wash. We have Parik as well joining. Good to see you, Parik. Hope everything's well over in London. Hope you're keeping busy now, keeping out of trouble. So what I'm going to do, just before we begin, I'm just going to ask Siobhan to join me. Siobhan's going to do the standing exercises today, and I'm going to do the seated exercises. All the same exercises, but just different variations. So before we begin any music, I'm just going to ask you just to join me as well. And just take three deep breaths, okay? So for anyone on the seat, just sit forward on the seat. Give Siobhan a big hello there as well.
Good morning, everyone.
Make our feet part of the gang. So we have our feet shoulder width apart, and we're sitting nice and tall. For those that are standing, feet shoulder width apart, slight bend in the knees, and again a nice tall posture. So I'm going to take my hands, we're going to place them here in the centre of the chest, elbows by the side, and we're going to breathe in through the nose, and as we do, we're going to lift the elbows up. So breathe in through the nose. And a big blow out through the mouth. And again. That's it. And one last time, in through the nose. And out through the mouth. I'm just going to ask Siobhan just to start the music. We can begin our warm up then. So again, we'll just loosen out. So we'll just rub the tops of the thighs. Rub the front of the legs. Back to the arms as well. Okay, and then just shake out the hands. Okay, so just a reminder, I'm going to do this. Same version of the exercise, Siobhan's going to do the standing, okay? So when we can, we're just going to march on the spot, just nice and easy, just starting off. And from there, we're just going to bring the hands back, close the fists, and then forward, we're rubbing out the palms. So back, and forth, back, and forth, that's it. Three more. Last two. Last one. And from there, we're just continuing to march in the spot. And what we're going to do, we're just going to bring the palms towards us. And away. Down. And up. And final time, down. And up. And we're going to keep them up now. And what we're going to do, we're just going to rotate them round. And then we're going to go the opposite way with both. Alright, and last time now, just all the way around. And all the way back. Great. Okay, stop, and then bringing the hands back down again and just continue to march on the spot. Hands by the side this time, palms facing out. We're just going to sit the elbows, the shoulders. I almost didn't get that one wrong. We're going to tip our shoulders and all the way up and back down. I think us Billy Gallmen are built differently now. We always pull more a different breed, so we have elbows for shoulders and shoulders for elbows. All the way down and back up. That's it, last two. And last one. All the way up and all the way down, okay? Both hands out in front now. And what we're going to do, hope I'm not going to get hit here, we're going to extend our elbows out to the side, our arms out and back in, out. And then that's it. I'm going to crisscross now. Just over and back. That's it. Feet are going at the same time whether you're seated or standing. Last three. Two. And last one. Hands by the side again. We're just going to lift up the shoulders just below our ears and we're going to roll them back. Okay. Up again. And roll it back. And last time up. And behind. And we're taking it up this time, we're going to roll them forward. Again, up and forward. And last one now, up. And just rolling it forward again. Great stuff. From there, just ask you to cross your arms, one on top of the other. Everyone, I'll ask you now just to plant the feet. Okay, so we're just going to twist around. We're going to hold for 2 seconds. Back to centre and to the left hand side. That's it. Out. And back in, back to the side, and then good stuff. So one more now off each side, and the last one off the other side, and we're back into our march again. And from there, what we're going to do, we're going to take down our march again. So we're just going to plant the feet, and we're just going to tap 1, 2, 3 out to the side, 1, 2, 3 back in. Okay, so lifting up that knee and back in, all the way out, as far as is comfortable for you. Back in, and last time now, all the way out, and all the way back in. Opposite leg now again, so pointing the toe, lift the heel off the ground, tap it out, 1, 2, 3, back in, 1, 2, 3, out and 3, back for 3, and last one now, out for 3, and back for 3, and we're just going to march in the squat again. And what we're going to do now with our right hand first, we're going to place the heel out in front, tap the toe behind. Out and back, that's it. Just nice and steady, getting that knee warmed up. Great stuff. That's 4, 3, 2, and 1. Same with the opposite leg now. So heel to the toe. Out and back. Great stuff. Last 3, 2. Last one, and our last one now, we're just going to switch the ankles, or for anybody standing, just lift up one ankle at a time and just roll it out. Okay, so just roll it around like so, change legs, hold it up in front, and just roll it around. That's it. Just shake out the ankles, shake out the legs, the arms, and the hands. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, we're going to go straight into our aerobic section. Okay, so we're trying to get the heart, the lungs working, and we're going to try and improve the circulation, get the blood all around the body, okay? So like before, just nice and easy, starting off, just marching on the spot. Okay, and what you can do then is just bring the arms in nice and easy, not too much now on the arms yet. We'll come to that in a bit. Alright, and you're going to march, if you're on the seat, you're going to march around to the right, and the same if you're standing, and you're going to march there. Then you're going to come back to the centre, keeping that high march, trying to get the arms up as well. All the way up, that's it. And we're going round to our left now, so all the way round. Marching on the spot, that's it. Arms up by the side and back to centre. Great stuff. We can slow down the pace now a little, okay? So what we'll do is call an active recovery. So we're not going to go as hard now. What we're going to do, we're just going to step out to the side. And right. So just stepping it out. Nice and easy, get the recovery. And then just to pick it up, what we're going to do, we're going to add in the arm on each side, okay? So like so, up. and out to the side. If you're doing it with a partner, I hope you're more in sync than myself and Siobhan here now. We'll not be winning any dance competitions anytime soon. Last 3, 2, and last one, and then we're just on the spot. So as I said, we're not dancers, but what we like to do sometimes, we like to box, not each other now, we're not that rough. So I'm just going to ask you, just as you're marching on the spot, just box now in front. We're obviously pros at this now. It's usually over the remote controls of the TV. And just reaching out. And we're reaching up now, up high. Reaching across your body. And if you can maintain the march, I'll ask you to do that as well. If not, you can just tap the feet. Last 4, 3, 2, and last one. March them on the spot last, but now we're just going to box down one at a time. Just down to the side. Up and down, that's it. Keep it on the march. Great stuff, last 3, 2, and one. We're going to go heel out now, one at a time. And again, just get a bit of active recovery there. Okay, we'll take down the heart rate a small bit. Give ourselves a bit of a breather. But we're moving at the same time. We're going to pick it up now. We're going to add in the arms at the side. So fingertips to shoulders. Not elbows. Shoulders. And from there, what we're going to do, we're just going to bounce the feet like this and proceed it. And Siobhan's just going to bounce her heels. And we're just going to imaginary skip at the side, okay? So we have our rope here. We'll go forwards, then we're going to go back. And again, we're just on the seat, we're bouncing the toes. Standing position, we're just lifting the heels. And then we're going to get fancy, we're going to crisscross over and back. That's it, and then back to standard. That's it, and then we're just back marching on the spot. And again, we're just going to lift one arm up at the front. At a time, right and left. Keeping the march going if you can. If not, as I said, you can just tap the feet in front, or you can tap the heels. Okay, so we're going to keep the feet marching if we can, and we're going to take the arms out in front now, and we're going to get a nice front crawl, okay? So just one arm at a time, all the way out in front, reaching that arm back, and then bringing it up and over. Elbow back, up and over. That's it, just nice and smooth. We have nice calm water today now. Current's not too strong. We can get from one end of the pool to the other. No hassle at all. And that's it, and then we're just going to come out for the breaststroke and back in. So anybody on the seat, just lean forward and back. And you can do the same as well if you're standing. Just lean a small bit forward. Pull the arms apart, take them back. And lean forward again. Out and back. That's it. Great stuff. We'll keep the feet flat for this one. Last 4, 3, 2, and last one. And just slowly just march it on the spot. I'll ask you then just to tap the front of your feet, keep the heels in the ground, and slowly just bring it to rest. Okay, so I'll just ask Siobhan just to turn off the music for us. If you need to grab a drink of water, take a wee sip now. Let us know how you feel after that. Okay, so a lot of big movements there. We get to say we're getting the heart rate up, we're getting the lungs working as well. So I'm just going to give you a second or two to see who's joining us. We have Jerry. Jerry, how are you? And we have Margaret as well. Margaret Franklin, so good to have you here with us, Margaret. So, as I said, we had a bit of a surprise for you at the end. Now, Siobhan, you might be surprised. She heard it was a test, so she's obviously just gone now. She's not as fit as the rest of us. So it's going to be not so much a test, perhaps. It's just going to be something to check progress. So it's 3 different small tests, just to check progress. There's no pass or fail on this, just for yourself to see how you're doing. And what it's going to do is just going to test the strength on the lower body and the upper body as well, and the last one then is just going to test balance. So just ask you whether you're standing or seated. If you can now, just come to your feet. Okay, and for those that are standing, if you can grab a chair as well and just stand in front of it. Make sure the back of the chair now is just sturdy, or I guess a sturdy surface or sturdy itself. And our first one is, I'll ask you all to sit down now. Okay, we're going to place our feet shoulder width apart. We're going to sit up nice and tall. And for our first test, it's going to be a minute long, so I'm just going to get our timer here. And what we're going to do is we're going to see how many sit to stands. So like so, just getting up into the standing position and slow on the way back down. We're going to see how many of those we can do in a minute. Okay. Some people may be able to do a lot, some people may be not able to do as much. Okay. Over the course of the minute, what I'd say is pace yourself. Okay. So if you find maybe after 5 or 6, you're getting tired, it's no harm to take a break for 10 seconds and you can start again, okay? You'll count them over the course of a minute. And the beauty of this is, if we keep moving and we keep doing these exercises as many days as possible, we'll increase that number day on day as well. So that's going to be our first one, and that can be done from the chair. So I'm just going to start the clock here, and 3, 2, and 1. So from this position, we're pushing the weight through the heels, standing up nice and tall, and then slowly lower the bottom to the seat. Okay, we're going to brace ourselves, we're going to stand up again, and slow on the way down, all the way up, and back down. As I say, this is not a race, this is just to give you an idea maybe of where you're at or where the strength in your legs are at the minute. And we're coming all the way up, so we're halfway there now. And back down, all the way up again, and back down. And if you find the arms in front of the chest too difficult, if you want to give yourself a little push, if you feel you need that, that's okay as well. Come back down. Ideally, we try to keep the arms in front, but if you feel you need that extra bit of support, I'd encourage you just to use your hands at the side as well. All the way up and back down. So we have 5 more seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Well done. Okay, take this breather, take your seat, make use of that seat, make use of the chair. I roughly, I think, did about 10 or 11 there. Okay, so that's not a bad score. I was taking my time with that as well. Okay, again, if you needed to stop at any stage during that, that's no problem at all. That can always be improved on as well. Okay, so just what I'd ask you to do is just make note of that number just for yourself. You don't have to share it with anyone. And what we'll try and do, we'll try and maybe retest, or we'll do this progress check again in a few weeks' time, okay, just to see the improvement on it. So our next one now, I'll ask you just to all stand up. And what you're going to need for the next one, we're going to target the upper body, mainly the chest and just the arms, the muscles in the back of the arm here. You're going to need a hard surface. What I'm going to like to use today, just for demonstration purposes, is just a mantelpiece here, which you could use as well. You could use a wall or a sturdy surface, okay? And I'll ask you just to stand nice and tall, facing your sturdy surface. You're going to put your hands either on the wall, it's a wall for you, or you're going to put them, as I'm going to do here, on the mantelpiece. Okay, and from there, you're going to tuck the elbows into the side, like so, as much as you can. And what you're going to do, you're going to bend the elbows so that you lower yourself towards that surface. So if it's a wall, you're going to be looking directly at the wall, and then you're going to straighten out your arms that you're standing up nice and tall again, okay? So you're going all the way down. You're going to stop at the bottom for a split second, and then you're going to push yourself back, okay? So we're not going to go too fast, we're going to go nice and steady and nice and controlled. And this will give us an indication then of the strength of our upper body and the strength of our arms at the moment, okay? If you find that with your feet too close to the wall, that's too easy, what I'll ask you to do, if you can see my feet now at the minute, is to just take one step back, okay? And this will make it a small bit harder, especially pushing back, okay? So whether you want your feet close or your feet a bit further away, that's completely up to you. And we're going to start, we're going to go for a minute again. In 3, 2, and 1, away we go. So again, we're stepping in position. We're going to lower the body, or move the body towards the wall with a hard surface, and we're going to come back. Okay, you can see my hands on the mantelpiece, have a good strong grip. and I'm coming back. Elbows are tucked in and back, that's it. So you're basically, you're just really just rocking back and forth, but be mindful just to stop when you lower yourself down, and then the same on the way up, okay? So all the way down and all the way up. And I'm going to take one step back just to make it a small bit more difficult for myself. And back. Last 20 seconds now. So if you have, keep counting the number of times you're doing this, okay? So from this position, down and back is one. Alright, so down and back, and that's 3 seconds. So I need one more in and back, and hold it there, folks. Okay, well done. Again, just take a step back now, just shake out the arms. Okay, you may need just to place your hands just at the base of your hips. Just open out that chest, okay? So again, that's a great indicator just of our upper body strength, you know, our chest muscles, and also the muscles just in the back of our arms, and our arms in general, really, okay? And the strength of our wrists pushing us back as well on that. Okay, so our last one now is going to be based around balance. And for anybody who might have been comfortable maybe balanced on one leg, what I'll ask them to do is just have your chair or a hard surface beside you, okay? And what we're going to do in this, we're going to lift one leg up off the ground, the other foot's going to be flat on the ground. And what I'll ask you to do, there's 3 levels to this, okay? So I'll ask you to do level 1, if you feel that you're not that steady on your feet, just grab the back of your chair and a steady surface. And take it away maybe, and put it down, take it away, and put it down as you need. Option 2, just hold that hand just above the chair. If you feel yourself getting a bit unsteady, that you can hold onto it to steady yourself up. And option 3 is just to take the hands away, like so. Okay, so again, what we're going to do here, we're going to do the right leg and the left leg, and we're going for our own time, so there's not going to be a minute limit on this. So if you can stay up for a minute or 2 minutes, great. If you can stay up for 6 hours, fantastic. Just make sure somebody gives you food later on, okay? You'll get hungry after a while, and then we're going to do the same up the opposite leg, okay? What you will find here, maybe that one leg will be stronger than the other. Generally, I will be stronger on my right side than my left. And again, over the next few weeks, we can do a few exercises to try and redress the balance on that as well, to make them just as strong as each other. So I'm just going to make note of my own time, and I'd ask you just to do the same. Same as to sit to stand, same, just pushing off the mantelpiece to the wall. Just note your score, keep it to yourself, okay? That's for you and for you only, and we can check back in a few weeks' time just to see your progress. Okay, so I'm going to start my timer here, and I'm going to lift the right leg off the ground, and the left foot's going to be steady, okay? So I'm just going to hold that now. I'm going to try it just with my hands away from anything. And as you can see, I'm fairly unsteady here. If there's a gust of wind now, I think I'd be down at this stage. All right. And if you find yourself unsteady, what I'd ask you to do maybe is just try and squeeze just the muscles in your tummy here. Okay? Because that'll give you a bit more steadiness. And then just breathe as normal. Okay? Definitely try not to hold your breath on this one. Just breathe as normal. Say your ABCs. That's a great way to breathe. Okay, I'm talking here, that's helping breathe. I'm not holding my breath. And I just hold it up. So I've gone there now 40 seconds. If you've put your feet down, that's okay. You can try and go again. And I'm just going to go for the minute now. As you can see, I'm taking a bit of a battering here now at the minute. So I'm just going to hover my hand over, just in case I need it. And for me, I'm just going for the minute. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, just shake it out. What I found there, folks, was maybe just the bottom of my foot, because I've kind of fallen arches. I found it maybe just a little bit strenuous, a little bit sore, okay? And if you find that yourself, I'd advise you just to stop, okay? Again, this is something we can build up session on session, day on day, and week on week, okay? So that's my left side up. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to change this to the right side, okay? So I'm going to take a chair over here. And again, what we want the support leg on the opposite side of the chair, if you're using the chair there. And just to give you something else, for anybody that wants to make it a bit more challenging. Okay, I'm going to start the clock, and I'm going to aim for a minute now. I mightn't get there, but I'm going to aim. This is my weak side now. So we're just standing on the spot. Okay, you may bring your hands out in front if you need. Out to the side. Just try and balance, and again, if you need to hold on to that chair, and if you're comfortable, take it away for a small bit, and then place it down, or just as I said before, even just hover over the top. And as I said, for anybody looking for a bit more of a challenge, what you can do is get an object, just either a cushion or a bottle, not a bottle of wine now, we don't want to spill any wine, all the way around. You can bring it back just to make it a bit harder. Okay, we're nearly there, so it'll be the last 10 seconds now for me. I'm getting a bit unsteady now, as you can see. I'll soon be out of shot if I go any further. And 3, 2, and 1, and relax. So, again, folks, just make note of that time. Keep it to yourself if you want to share, by all means, share, but that's completely for you. And as I say, we can check your progress in the next few weeks. So, the last thing to do now, just before we go, grab a sip of water now to eat. Keep hydrated. It's getting very warm these days, folks, so make sure you're hydrated now. Keep taking the water during the day. I know the temperatures are starting to rise, so it's important to keep hydrated in that as well. So the test is over now. Siobhan's conveniently going to come back. She's missed the whole test. She's going to come back and join us now for the stretching. And again, if you're doing it in the standing position, just follow Siobhan. If you're in the seated position, just follow myself. It's quite similar anyway as it is, okay? So again, just sitting or standing nice and tall. If you're on the chair, just come to the front of the chair. Hands on the lap. If you're standing, hands on the side. And you're just going to lift the chin around the right shoulder. Just hold it there. Back to centre. Now over your left shoulder. Hold it there. Back to centre again. Okay, and from there, you're just going to take your chin out to your chest. So just lower it down. Just looking at the ground, hold it there. And back up the centre again. Okay, so I'll ask you now just to reach both hands out in front, one at the top, or one set of fingers behind the other, or in front of the other, as the case may be. And we're just reaching out, stretching the upper back. And we're looking straight ahead. And again, our posture is nice and tall. From there then, I'll just ask you to take away the hands and just place them just in the backs of your hips. Lift that chin up, look straight ahead, and try and bring your elbows closer together. Just hold the stretch there. Okay, and the exercise that we were doing, or the little test that we were doing, pushing back from the wall or pushing back from the mantelpiece, okay, that would have been, a lot of that would have been with the chest muscles. This is a great stretch for it, so just bring it back. So over the next few days, if you feel yourself a bit tender in that area maybe, that's a great stretch there for it as well. The last thing to do now is just, if you're on the chair, just grab the front legs of the chair and just lean down to the right hand side. Okay, the same if you're standing, just run the hand down the outside of your thigh, or outside of your leg. Take it back up to centre, down to the left hand side. And that's it. And back up the centre. And then we're just going to move to the legs then. So we'll ask you just to stretch your right leg out in front. Slight bend of the knee. Don't log out the knee. Point your toe away from you. Hands on the opposite lap. And just lean forward. If you're in a standing position, you're just going to lower the bottom just a little bit to the ground. And hold that stretch. So this is the hamstring. I'm going to stretch the calf as well. So to stretch the calf, we're going to maintain this position and just lift the toe towards us. Okay, so you'll feel that a bit more in the lower leg of the calf, as it's called. Okay, and from there we're going to sit back nice and tall again. Left leg extended out in front. Right hand on the right lap, and just lean it forward. Stay nice and tall, keep that chin up. And that's it, and now pull the toes towards you. And hold that there as well. Back up to centre. Just shake out the ankles, just a nice little shake. And to finish off now, I'll just invite you again just to take your hands to the centre of your chest. You're going to inhale through your nose and lift up your elbows either side at the same time. And inhale. And last time. The eyes closed, just relax the hands just on top of the laps. front of your thighs. Just take a second for yourself. And when you're ready, just slowly open the eyes. Okay. Give yourselves a clap. A high five or something above you. Well done, folks. Great work. Now I'm just going to get back to my standing position. I'm just going to ask, thanks Siobhan for all her help this week. Just ask her to turn off the music there for us. Just before we go, just one or two things I'd just like to mention that you may not be aware of, that's on this Age and Opportunity Facebook page and also on our website and the Age and Opportunity YouTube page as well. And the first one started last week. The video is up on Facebook and YouTube from 11 a.m. on Saturday mornings. It's an arts initiative with the artist Tom Meskell, and he's going to show you, I suppose, how you can be creative with everyday items in your household. And we had a great one with bubble wrap last week, so I'm looking forward to seeing what he has tomorrow. And I also want to give a mention to Beatina. So for anybody who doesn't know Beatina, it's a festival that Age and Opportunity run in May of each year. It takes place all around Ireland. Unfortunately, this year, with the way things are, we had to cancel, but we have improvised, I suppose, the people and my colleagues on the arts team have improvised that they're going to deliver that through Facebook, their own Facebook page. So if you type for Beatina on Facebook, it'll bring you through there. And they've a number of arts and creativity initiatives there for the month of May that I'm sure you'll enjoy. You know, there's book clubs, there's photography clubs, there's various events, there's dawn course. So I'd ask you, if you have an interest in the arts and creativity side of things, I'd encourage you to tune into that and to see what events are going on. So we're going to be back here as normal on Monday at 11 a.m. for a seated session. We're going to be back. We're going to be doing a bit of sweeping this week as well. Okay. So again, if you can wrestle the sweeping brush off your husband for maybe a half an hour on Monday morning, I'd encourage you just to join us as well for that. Again, thanks so much for joining us all week and continuing to tune in. We're in week eight now. I'm starting to get tired, obviously, but we're week eight now. Again, thanks very much for joining us, and we really, really appreciate it. And we love the interaction, we love the comments. And I'm just going to see now a few there. With Margaret, Franklin, you're very welcome, Margaret. And Howard Ann, still up, but Mark, they're still up and doing all. No better place, Mark. I'll swap if you want. And we also have Aideen Fury. Olivia, you know, the Wi-Fi is causing you a bit of trouble, so you might catch us later. Kathleen, we have Rosari and Rosweeney, Teresa Cullinan. Great numbers in the day. Jerry, Ross Barrett, thanks for tuning in. Fiona, I hope you got John involved now. I hope you got him into the partner. So it's great. Look, we love the interaction, and we hope you enjoy it too. We enjoy delivering the exercises, and we hope that you're getting benefit from them. So I'm going to go now and grab a cup of tea, and I'll see you back here on Monday at 11 a.m. Stay active, and most importantly, stay well.